Cinema Local. Mi nombre es Grisel Rosales y el día de hoy les traigo mucha información acerca del Festival de Cortometraje Universitario de la UVAC. Tuvimos la oportunidad de hablar con Ariel Casimiro, el director de Idol Worship. Vamos a ver qué tiene que decirnos.
I wanted to actually go study at in America actually.
Oh, okay.
In Hollywood. I wanted to do film. I didn't decide I wanted to do film. I wanted to go to Hollywood. So I applied at USC. I don't know if you know USC. So, and I had no money. There was no way I was gonna be able to pay for the tuition. So I was praying for a scholarship. But like, yeah, but the application, I had to do like a video. So I did a video, and then that was like my first experience. And then obviously, I didn't get accepted because I didn't have money. And then yeah, then I enrolled in film school. In film school, we did like a bunch of films, like you guys are probably studying. Like, the good thing is we had a lot of practice. It wasn't a lot of theory, it was a lot of practical. And we were doing like some cool stuff. So I started working in commercials. And then while I was doing like small like film projects, but like, yeah, I finished school and I started doing like other stuff as well, music videos, commercials, and I came here. And I opened my own production company. It's called Usovoli Cinema. And then the goal was sort of to do more fictional work. That was the goal of my company, to do a lot of fiction here in Angola. So I think what I use in my films, like to show African cultures, like the biggest thing right now is music. Music is like the biggest thing that I use now to show African culture. Obviously, it doesn't work all the time, so I try to never make it feel like it's forced. Like in Idol Worship, I was thinking I would put like an African song to it. I was like, yeah, it's not working. I think it was like, I think the poetry just, it moved me in a weird way. Like that was the initial reaction. I listened to the poetry and I felt something immediately. I was like, okay. And then when I feel something, I told myself like I need to do it. If I feel something, because if I felt something, then probably someone else will also feel what I feel. And then like, I just liked how passionate she was about her poetry. Like, but like you can hear like her aggressiveness and how passionate she is about her message. Then if she can like give that kind of performance when we're shooting her, then this is gonna be quite good.
Número 1. Idol Worship. Un cortometraje que te hace sentir cada palabra del poema que se recita en él. De la mano de la increíble actuación de Yaliya The Bird, también escritora del poema, podemos ver todos los sentimientos expresados en él sobre la lucha de género en Angola, África.
Este corto documental trata sobre las enfermedades mentales.
Número 2. ¿Sí me entiendes? Una producción muy personal. Si me entiendes, te muestra de manera cruda cómo es vivir con una enfermedad mental a través de la vida de tres personas con desórdenes mentales. Muy buenas historias y una manera amable de presentar estos padecimientos a través de tomas muy cercanas de los protagonistas. Número 3. Matiné. La palabra perfecta para describir a este corto es inesperado. Tiene un plot twist muy interesante y divertido. Además de la historia, los colores y tomas de esta producción son muy agradables de ver. Sin duda mi favorito en cuanto a cuestiones de arte y fotografía. Cuéntanos, ¿cuáles fueron tus cortometrajes favoritos? Esto fue todo por hoy, espero que les haya gustado muchísimo. Nos vemos en el próximo video, no olviden contarnos cuáles fueron sus cortometrajes favoritos. Yo soy Grisel Rosales y nos vemos en la próxima aquí en Cinema Local.